welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're brand new. I'm very happy that you decided to join me today for another speed build, and today we're building another base game house. If you're not new here on the channel, you know that I love building base game only builds in general, because when it comes to base game, I feel always super creative to come up with my custom furniture. And with custom furniture, I don't mean that I use custom content, because I do not, but I mean that I create new furniture with items that are already in game. Either I rotate them with tool, or I don't know, maybe I grab some things from the debug menu and, you know, just, I don't know, get creative, I guess. But yeah, so that's what we are doing today. And also, exciting thing, because finally I'm building a family home, because lately I've been gravitating more towards smaller builds, just because they're quicker to do, and with university it's not that I have a whole lot of time, you know, to dedicate to The Sims. So yeah, sometimes it's nice to build something smaller and quicker, but not this time. This house is fairly big. It's not as big as a mansion, obviously. I wouldn't even have the patience to furnish like 10 bedrooms. It's not me, it's not for me, thank you. But yeah, this house has 3 bedrooms and 2 bathrooms, and little disclaimer before I forget about it, I didn't include the footage of the bathrooms just because I didn't want this video to be too long. So yeah, you won't see the bathrooms like being built, but there are bathrooms. This is not a bathroomless house, don't worry, I'm not EA, I do not forget toilets. But yeah, let's not go there. If you want to see the bathrooms, you will see them in the cinematic tour at the end of this video, because of course I have a cinematic tour at the end of this video. But an exciting thing I did with this build, well, not with this build, but in general, is that I created my own custom gallery art. Gallery art is no CC art. You can find plenty of it on the gallery, and it's free for everyone, also for console players, and it makes builds look so much more realistic. It's like so much prettier than the art we normally have in game. And yeah, since I found out about gallery art, I haven't used the art we have available in game anymore, because I just don't like it. I prefer gallery art. But yeah, all of this to say that I've come up with my own gallery art, and I've created some modern drawers. I have like 2 versions, and I'm using one in this build. You can see these modern drawers that I'm using in this kitchen. And the funny thing is that to make this design, like with these wide, modern, beautiful drawers, I've used a base game item, actually. It's a dresser. It's the dresser that dresser would have so much potential, but instead of making the edges straight, they made them like inclined. Like, the edges are not perpendicular to the floor, they're like inclined. I don't know if it makes sense, I don't know if you understood what I wanted to say, but yeah, the bottom line is that dresser could have been so cool, but yeah, they wasted it. Yeah, so I've come up with my own gallery art to make up for it. And obviously it's base game compatible, otherwise I wouldn't be using it in this build, duh. And if you want to grab my gallery art, you can find it on my gallery. My ID is JulaBuilds. You can find also this house, obviously, on my gallery, and yeah, my ID is JulaBuilds. Needless to say, I guess. Also, in this house, I've been using the tool mod like crazy. Well, not a news also here. I always use the tool mod, but if you're new and you may wonder what's the tool mod is a mod created by Twisted Maxi, so big shout out to Twisted Maxi, which allows everyone to rotate things, scale them up and down, and raise them up and down with more precision, because obviously we can already scale things up and down, and we can raise them up and down with some keyboard shortcuts. I mean, according to your country, they will be slightly different, but yeah, we can already do that. But with the tool mod, we can do it with so much more control, which is so fun. And also, as you can see, I'm using it right now to create this custom bookshelf, because I don't like none of the bookshelves from the base game. They are so ugly. So yeah, of course I had to come up with my own one. And I've used Gallery Art and just the Basecamp shelf to create this design. And the tool mod was fundamental for it because I was able to rotate the Basecamp shelves vertically instead of them like sitting horizontally. I hope everything I'm saying makes sense. Obviously, explaining thing is not my strength. So yeah, I hope you understood what I wanted to say. But yeah, all of this to say that the tool mod is awesome and I cannot build without it. So if you're a builder, I highly suggest you try and download the tool mod if you play on your computer, because obviously, unfortunately, console players cannot access mods or CC. But the good thing of the tool mod is that if you download this build, everything I've rotated or raised up or whatever I did will stay as you see. So yeah, that's really cool. I love this mod for this reason. So actually, even console players could, you know, exploit the tool mod, because if you download this house and, for instance, you like the bookcase, just like draw a room around the bookcase and just save it on your library, and then you can plop the bookcase in your builds if you want to use it. So yeah, I love the tool mod, if it wasn't clear enough. And also, an exciting news about the tool mod, given that we are talking about it, is that this Thursday, like this week on Thursday, there will be an update for the tool mod, and now we will be, well, now on Thursday, we will be able to use the tool mod also in build mode, because now, as of now, at least, to use the tool mod you have to switch into live mode, but I mean, starting from Thursday, we won't have to do that anymore, which is so nice, and I cannot wait to have this new feature. But yeah, if you're not a tool mod user, maybe you won't understand my excitement, but yeah, I guess that's just a personal preference, I should say. But I think I'm well proud about this build. Well, I like the whole interior overall. I went with a bit of a darker color scheme. I've used a lot of blacks and wooden tones, but like on a more darker side. Except from in the toddler's room, which is white. So it's like the opposite of the whole house, but I'm so proud of that room because I created the cutest bed like I've ever done, and I hope you're going to like it as well. It should be coming up soon, actually. But now we are working on the master bedroom. So yeah, this master bedroom has mostly brown tones, but I've used some hints of black as well, just because I think that the master bedroom should follow the general color scheme of the house, while with kids' room you can be a bit more free when, you know, choosing color schemes. But yeah, I really like how this bedroom turned out. I've used a lot of mirrors to make it look a bit bigger, because that's actually an interior design trick. It's mostly used like in tiny homes and small spaces. If you use big mirrors or mirrors in general, this space will look bigger, because obviously mirrors amplify, you know, the space or whatever. I'm not technical on these things. And another fun thing I did is I created my own custom sort of wardrobe thingy. I've used a couple of kitchen cabinets. I've rotated them so they are facing the wall, like this is the back of the cabinet, the one you're seeing, and then I've combined some dressers to make them look like handlers or drawers. So yeah, that's what I did. But now we are working on the kids' room, and now you are seeing me like placing a bed, placing a room, and, you know, just plop a bed there. And actually, it's not like I've stolen this bed from someone, I've stolen it from myself, because I've created this bed like in the past. It was in another one of my base game houses, and it was just like right before Snow White Escape came out, something like that. It was that period, and I've created that bed with, you know, all the wooden pieces rotated, and I wanted this look for this bedroom, but I couldn't be bothered in doing it again, so I just took my own room and just plopped the bed there. Yeah, I'm lazy like that, but yeah, it's understandable, I guess, because it's a bit tedious to rotate all those wooden planks, like, yeah, you have to find the correct angle, and yeah, I didn't want to do that again, so I just plopped my own room there, which is also the thing that I usually do when I place decorative ladders, which I also placed in this build, but you're not going to see it because it's in one of the bathrooms. But yeah, it's a trick I always use actually, so yeah, nothing new there. But anyway, for the kids room, like the previous kids room before I started blubbering, I wanted to add also that I've done like a jungle theme, so I've used that leafy wallpaper that came with the base game. I love that wallpaper, but I never get the chance to use it, and in this room it was just perfect. And what inspired the jungle theme room is actually the gallery art I've used on the shelf on top of the desk. But yeah, I'm now talking about the kids room that it's not on your screen anymore. And actually I've talked over also the toddler room, and probably you could see, but I've created my custom bed, and I've used a bookshelf which has a sort of a shape of a house, like the top of the bookshelf has a shape shaped like a roof, like a gabled roof I think, and I've used shelves to mimic the shape of the roof so that it could look like a sort of canopy bed. The inspiration was actually the toddler bed we got with the Eco Lifestyle pack, which is one of the prettiest beds ever. But now, as you can see, we're already onto the exterior, and like that fireplace area on the exterior was actually what inspired this whole house, because I saw a picture on Pinterest which had this beautiful outside fireplace area, and I wanted to recreate it, and yeah, so I did it. I would actually love to have such like an outdoor space. Obviously I should also have money to be able to, you know, afford such a house, but yeah, let's not go there. I have to say, let's stick to The Sims and let's dream, I think, I guess. But we are actually at the end of this video. As you can see, I'm just finishing up with the landscaping and it's finished already. I really hope you like this video, and as always, I'm talking more than I should given that the tour has already started. And yeah, I let you just enjoy the tour, I guess. But if you like this video, please leave a like and a comment and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. It would help me so much. And yeah, hopefully I'll see you all in my next video on Monday. Bye!